In high school, they may have taught you how to perform a matrix-matrix multiplication, but did they teach you why matrix-matrix multiplication is defined the way it is? In this unit, we're going to look at exactly that, because we're not satisfied with just knowing how to do something. We want to know why we do it. Okay, so let's have a look and see where a matrix-matrix multiplication comes from. It all starts with this question. If you have two linear transformations, L of A and L of B, and you define a new linear transformation LC, such that if you plug in a vector x, you evaluate that x with linear transformation B, and then you take the result of that and you plug it into linear transformation A. Now, if the vector that goes in is of size n, then that goes in there as well. What that means is that the linear transformation B has to take a vector of size n into some other size, let's call it k. So out comes a vector of size k. What that means is that input for the linear transformation A must be of size k. And then the output of linear transformation A is of some size, let's call it m. And notice that, therefore, the linear transformation C has to take a vector of size n into a vector of size m. All right, so why don't you take a break? Why don't you try to go and prove this? Well, first of all, decide whether it's always, sometimes, or never true. And then if you think it's always true, go and prove that LC is actually a linear transformation. Okay, we're back. And notice that it's always a linear transformation. And why is it always a linear transformation? Well, we have to ask these two questions. Is it the case that if you scale the vector first and then transform it, you get the same vector as if you first transform it and then you scale it? And the second question you have to answer is it the case that if you add vectors first and then transform, you get the same answer as if you first transform and then add? And notice that if you plug this in, you know what the definition of L sub C is. You then know that L sub B is a linear transformation, so you can bring the alpha out. And then you know that L of A is a linear transformation, and therefore you can bring the alpha out. And then you recognize that this is just that. Similarly, if you add first and then transform, you can plug that into your L of B, your L sub B transformation, and then into your L sub A transformation. And if you just work through the fact that L sub B is a linear transformation and then L sub A is a linear transformation, lo and behold, you get exactly the result that you wanted. What we notice is that composing two linear transformations is itself a linear transformation. Remember, composition is if you take some function g and then you take the result of that and you plug it into some other function f, then you come up with a new function h, and that new function is called the composition of functions f and g. There are a bunch of different matrices involved, and there's a relation between the sizes that these matrices must be. Okay? Now, notice that the vector that goes into linear transformation B has to be the same vector that goes into the linear transformation C. Therefore, we conclude that n sub C must be equal to n sub B. The vector that comes out of the linear transformation L sub A must have the same size as the vector that comes out of linear transformation C. From that, we conclude that m sub C must be equal to m sub A. Whatever comes out of L sub B has size m sub B, and that is fed into the linear transformation L sub A. Therefore, this size must be the same as that size. Now, if you summarize all of that, what you find out is that the number of rows in A must be the same as the number of rows in C. The number of columns in B must be the same as the number of columns in C. And then this here is often called the inner dimension, and that has to match as well. So there really are only three sizes involved, M, N, and K. Everything else is determined from how these actually have to match. The simple observation is that if L sub A and L sub B are linear transformations, and you define L sub C this way, then you find out that L sub C is a linear transformation. There are matrices associated with L sub A and L sub B. There is a matrix associated with the new linear transformation L sub C. And the operation that computes C from these matrices A and B is called matrix-matrix multiplication. And the notation we're going to use is that C is equal to A times B. And if you're applying C to some vector X, that's the same as applying the result of A times B to vector X, which is the same as first applying B to X and then applying A to the result.